Ralph Webb, all Aaron, Peters, and Williams, and Hillman to join us this evening. Today is the day of celebration. So without the constant support and love of our parents, along with the guidance of our teachers, here it is to have the number of years back. It wasn't until the beginning of the school year that I realized that my time at PHS was coming to an end. These past 4 years have been full of them, and until now, nothing really was found. There was always another semester or another school year, but today marks the conclusion of our high school career. These 4 years have been thrown back behind us, leaving behind us only loving memories of high school. It was 4 years of exciting new experiences, and it was 4 years of learning and fun. For some of us, it was the first year. For some, it was the first year of our work. But for others, maybe it was the first job or the first time having a little car. A great deal has happened in these 4 years we have spent with each other. Most important is perhaps the appearance of change. We have become smarter and more social and more aware of what the future has in hold for us. We can no longer be called boys or girls because we have grown to young men and women. Now is the grand turning point in our lives. We will be on our own, and we will be tested on whether we can survive life with our parents and families in high school for me. The skills and lessons learned in high school carry over into adulthood. I am convinced that our senior class is more than capable of overcoming all obstacles life has in store. But whether it was going to winning points in a basketball game or finally getting that age on the test, I think that it is reasonable to say that we all have our own destinies. And people to thank them. On behalf of the class of 2008, we want to thank our parents for always being there and never accepting anything less than our duty. We know it was hard, and we love you today. Thanks to our families, friends, and fellow students for your support and encouragement. Thanks to the principal and staff at Pisgah. I'm sure that our class has not always been easy to deal with, but you somehow put up with it. Over the course of my life, especially high school, I have learned that goodbyes will always hurt. Pictures will never replace having been there. Memories, good or bad, will bring tears, and words can never replace them. To the class of 2008, congratulations. We are finally at the point in our life where we have longed for. Since the end of kindergarten, all of our hard work and struggle, right elementary, middle, and high school, finally paid off. It is also proven that today is not the end. We can make it.
And now I would like to introduce this year's valedictorian, Sydney Archie.
Good evening. First, giving honor to God, I would like to thank him for allowing all of us to be here tonight. Dr. Sessions, who's been a wonderful principal, Mr. Gates, our assistant principal, the faculty and administration and staff, our honored guests, friends and family, and to my fellow graduates. Thank you for being here and thank you for supporting us all in this time of celebration. It is truly a blessing and an honor for us to have made it this far, and I am pleased to stand before you today. I would also like to thank the teachers for their loyalty to us seniors. I would like to recognize our senior sponsors, Mrs. Christian, Kirk Reynolds, and Mrs. Adams. They have been awesome this year, and they have made our year worthwhile. On behalf of my classmates, we would also like to thank the parents for all their hard work and commitment to us. Lastly, I would like to give thanks and praise to God for being God. Without him, none of us would be here. Tonight, we celebrate one of our greatest accomplishments in life, our high school graduation. We made it through elementary, junior high, and now finally through high school. Today begins some of the best years of our lives, only to live new hopes and dreams that we were all destined to accomplish in this life. Each of us is different and special in our own way, but this is the way God made us. He has a special purpose for all of us that he wants us to live up to. Here in this class, we have potential doctors, lawyers, preachers, teachers, pilots, athletes, dentists, mechanics, and even farmers. We are the future, however, it is up to us to make a difference in the world today and fulfill our destiny. Many people enter this world only to leave it without ever being here. What I mean by this statement is that many people were born to do great things, but they either feared it or they didn't pursue after it, and they did not fulfill their purpose at all. We, the class of 2008, do not want to live the same lifestyle. Do not allow fear to control your lives and get the best of you. 2 Timothy 1:7 states, "For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Do not fear your destiny and hide behind the shadow. Come forth, rise, and become who you were meant to be." Just because something is difficult doesn't mean you shouldn't try. It only means that you should try hard. You'll always miss 100% of shots that you never take. Failure is not an option for any of us. We should pray for success, we shall believe for success, and one day we will be a success. Follow your heart and live your passion. Just because you mess up 100 times does not mean that you give up. It just means that you find 100 ways that do not complete the task. A quote by Mark Twain reads, 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did. So throw off the bowline, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade wind through your sails, explore, dream, and discover. Success does not come in a day, a week, or even a month. It comes from a lifetime of hard work, dedication, and commitment. Many of us will reach success before others, but we must keep our heads held high and our eyes on Christ. Watch your thoughts, they become words. Watch your words, they become actions. Watch your actions, they become habits. Watch your habits, they become your character. Watch your character, it becomes your destiny. I can truly say that I have had an awesome experience as a student of history. I've enjoyed the teachers and the students. I also loved the field trip that Dr. Session took us on for our role, and he did, and all he did, rewards for our academic achievements. Of all the years in school, I will always remember my senior year. This year, we made many memories and forged bonds with people that will last a lifetime. I know that we are all about to part, but we should keep our memories and bonds in our hearts. We will now go our separate ways and live new lives. We will meet new people, experience new ideas and behaviors. Remember the morals and the values that our parents have taught us. We are a representation of them, and we want them to be proud to say that we are their sons and daughters. We must keep a positive mind and keep God with us wherever we go. What we are is God's gift to us. What we become is our gift to God.
On behalf of the Rankin County Chamber of Commerce, we have a special presentation in which we would like to recognize years of service for the following people. 5 years, Shannon Boyd. 5 years, Cindy Christian. With 15